Another reason not to reuse passwords. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a comment I got just recently. It's a good idea to get a feel for how strong your password is. There are plenty of password strength tools online. You don't need to put your password into some random website. I would never recommend that. But having a good sense of the strength or weakness of your password is really important. Setting aside for a moment that using an online password strength meter actually is entering your password into a random website online, I disagree. I actually disagree with this person's comment, and I want to explain why. You don't need a password strength tester. However, you do want to use what I will call a password found tester. Let me explain why. First of all, strong passwords, you know what? They're easy. They should be easy. If you're using a password vault, as you should be, then that password vault probably comes with a password generator. I know that mine does. I'm currently using 1Password, and it comes with a password generator that will give me a 20-character string of completely random characters. What more do you want? That's a random password. It's simple, it's easy, and it doesn't require any extra steps. Use a password vault to save your passwords, and then use that vault's password generator to generate new passwords as you need them. You don't need to remember them if you're using a password vault. So, let's talk about reused passwords. It turns out that using the same password at multiple different sites is probably the single riskiest thing you can do when it comes to your online security. Here's why. Let's say you generate one of these wonderfully random long passwords and you use it at both site A and site B. You feel like you're secure because it's a strong password. Nobody's going to guess it. They don't have to. Whichever of these two sites, A or B, has the worst security could potentially put your password at risk. So let's think for a moment. Let's say that site A is great. They do security right. Site B, not so much. They actually store the password in plain text or in some way where the plain text version of the password can be recovered. They shouldn't, but for whatever reason, they're doing security wrong. They get hacked. Now, all of a sudden, hackers have a copy of your password because site B was doing security wrong. Through no fault of yours, site B got compromised. Your password, as strong as it is now in the wild. And as we've said before, hackers are now going to take that password and start running it along with your user ID against all of the major services, including, for example, whatever service A is, right? So you're using it at site A. Site A does security right, but because site B didn't, your password that you used at both site A and site B has been exposed, and hackers will eventually sign in as you at site A. Don't reuse passwords. Here's the not quite as obvious scenario. Let's say you don't use the same password at two different sites. You never have. But for whatever reason, maybe you have a set of passwords that you like to come back to because they're long and they're strong, but they're easy for you to remember. So you sign into site A, you create site A's password, you make it one of these nice, long, strong passwords that you have. Eventually, for whatever reason, you change the password on site A. Okay, cool. Site A continues to be protected. Never, ever use that first password again. Because if site A got compromised, or if you got compromised by the keylogger or something else, if that password was ever captured by hackers, they remember it forever. So even though you might be using the same password on different sites, but only one of them at a time, that's not good enough. You need to never, ever reuse passwords, because if they are ever exposed, they get thrown into databases of passwords we've found maintained by hackers. And when they attempt brute force attempts at other compromises in the future, they don't start by trying all possible passwords. They start by trying all passwords they've found so far. And what that means is if your password is in that list, even because you've used it exactly and only once, it's essentially available for them to try as much as they might want to try in the future. That's why, instead of using a password strength meter, I more strongly recommend you use a password found site. Now, the site that I use is called Have I Been Pwned, and they have a service called Pwned Passwords. All that really is a site where you enter one of your passwords, and it tells you if that password has ever been discovered in one of the breaches that Pwned Passwords knows about. If it has, stop using that password. Do not use that password, because the hackers know that that exists as a password, and they will try it against whatever they run across in the future. Now, I have to be clear, Pwned Passwords is not a canonical list. It's a list, and it's a very big list, and absolutely, if your password shows up there, you shouldn't be using it. But they're not a canonical list. For all we know, hackers have multiple different lists that haven't been exposed, that Pwned Passwords doesn't have knowledge of. All you can do there is what we've been saying over and over and over again for such a long time. Don't use the same password at multiple sites. And now let's augment that. Don't use a password more than once, ever. Because if it's ever been exposed, it's going to be in one of these databases. Now, one of the things that can help a lot is two-factor authentication. Remember, with two-factor authentication enabled, even if hackers do know the password, they can't sign in. And that's ultimately what you really, really want. So do that. Enable two-factor authentication wherever you possibly can, but regardless of two-factor being in place, don't reuse passwords simultaneously or ever. Hope that helps. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/151962. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.